So you have seen the G3 frame in action, and that was a very stable, really sturdy, really powerful frame. Now I have the G4X and have four motors, 170 kV. I transfer everything from G3 to G4 frame. New plates, all the hardware is new. Put all this together. It was a complicated but very fun process. But I want to mention the speed controllers. After trying the dual 6.6 200 amps AC, I needed a controller that packs similar power but had a smaller footprint and work with 4x4 system. Unfortunately, the older version was not capable of 4x4 low, so I went with 6.6 plus, and this AC so far is amazing. Here are the specs. I use a lot of fog boxes, and they're great for 10S, but for 12S, they're not that great, especially for 4x4. This is a brand new fog box. I was just setting it up. It exploded while I was just doing the motor detection. Poor quality. At least it should survive the setting and maybe a couple of runs. I came online across several Unity complaints. People are getting more and more malfunctions. Recently, I have a very close friend that also had a crash and got hurt. Also destroyed his board due to Unity issues.
Going out for a test drive. Remote is not even pressed. What the fuck? Oh my god. Did a burnout and everything.
Be careful when you build DIY project and make sure you buy the best parts. So I did use FlipSky, and I have two of them tucked in here inside. I made this plate, I epoxied for, this is 6S, so in series there will be 12S. And here's the connector I made for 12S. So you just plug it in like that, and you connect them there, so it will be 12S. I have on this speed controllers about 300 miles on the G3 frame, and I never had any issues. The setting was so easy, so fast. I set up one as a master and the one as a slave, and I put the CAN bus wire, and they saw each other. Both work super well. So I definitely recommend for off-road system, 50 to 100 amps, this speed controller are amazing. The G3 was CNC'd, every part was super strong. This is actually welded, so it's cut or water jet and then welded. This is actually casted. It has advantages. So this frame actually turns so much better. It has maybe like 3 to 5 degrees more steering when you have low speeds. And that's the problem with the big boards. When you have high speed, G3 turns amazingly well. The same with this board. When you have low speeds, G3 actually would give you some trouble. If you have to do steep turns, the G3 would not be so great. And you have here steering adjustments. You can place, there's a thread here, there's a hole on top, one on the bottom. So when moving this steering arm, you actually increase the turnability. You can adjust that, and there's a lot of settings here to adjust rebound, how fast you want to, there's a knob right here, how fast you want the shock to respond. It's just, you know, I put every single piece together, and the engineering is just amazing. The precision and everything is so well done. But going back to the speed controllers, I also use their new remote, it's really cool. Let me guys show you quickly. So you have, it's not connected now, but shows you the power of the board, the power of the remote, the distance you travel, and the amps you were drawing. And also you can adjust, and actually it works when you have the load, when you stand on it. You can go low, medium, and high speeds. Really, really cool. Really like this remote. For racing, what I prefer is the DIY. I think I have more control, more range, and it's just easier to accelerate and control the board at 30 plus to 40 miles an hour. I have not tested this going really fast, but normal 25, 33 plus miles an hour, this remote is amazing. Really good control, really comfortable ergonomic grip, really, really cool. And lasts a long time, has a really big battery inside, so lasts you for many rides. The speed controllers with this system, I have 170 kV motors, works perfectly. I weigh 225 pounds, and I have not used or found any better AC than this. Definitely, if you have a powerful system and you need a small compact AC, this is the one to go. It has a good price and amazing performance. And what's cool about the FlipSky is that I have here the wires that run to the motor. So it's two, you know, it's 4x4. So two speed controllers here, and they connect here to the motor. So as you guys know, the shorter the wire, the better. Less rip voltage going back, and it would not harm the speed controllers. I have here in the back almost like 26 inches of wire. So here is the second speed controller on the top, and it connects to the motors in the back. And if I put the fog box, they will not last too long because of the rip voltage and the current going back. And the speed controller, this doesn't have a chip that controls the spike in the voltage. Now this controller works very well with this length of the wires. It does not affect the performance, and I have never came across a speed controller that will be so reliable, and so it actually has a chip that actually controls the voltage. So I never came across speed controllers that actually have that feature. I use Castle Creation, which are 3 times more expensive and even more powerful. They can deliver 300 amps, but once you put wires longer than like 7 or 5 inches, they burn. You have to put caps, and having those caps, we'll say 6 months, a year, year and a half, will just mess up electronics, and eventually is gonna kill the controller. These speed controllers handle that no problem. So that's one thing to take in consideration if you build an electric bicycle or a board that's actually bigger than this, or let's say a go-kart, and you need to run wires. This speed controller would do amazingly well. I reviewed in the past a while back the dual 6.6 200 amp speed controller. Also amazing product, really really powerful. It's almost matching this speed controller, but why this is better, look at the size. Like, this is an amazing AC, but I would not be able to fit it here. Look how big it is, right? This speed controller delivers the same almost output, but look how compact it is. And by the way, I'm still using this speed controller on other boards. This one really had never gave me any trouble. It performs every single time. Amazing speed controller. So just to show you how complex this board is and how well engineered it is, it's just amazing. Every single piece connects with the frame and works in tandem. It's just amazing. I have to put this plate back today. I wanted to do something cool. I wanted to put here some, like I want to make a holder for two 18650s and put a light here. So I have LEDs in the front, like the G3, and have a brighter output. But the frame is just beautiful. Really amazing board. So everything is done here. Here are my balance wires. So I never use BMS. If you watch my previous videos, I don't trust BMS. So I always charge with a balance charger, and I use the iCharger for the last 18 years. The best, I think they're the best chargers in the market. All right, guys, so this is the update. This is the ESCs and the remote. If you have any other questions about this product, please place comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next video.